Dear students, I welcome you all on the e-learning platform of KTHM College. And this is Sanjay Rathod is here. Dear friends, in the present video, we'll try to discuss some elements from communication skills under the course of Mastering Communication Skills. Dear friends, it is important as to know what is communication. Communication is the imparting or exchanging of information by speaking, writing, or using some other medium. Then, next component is that what is a language? Language we use in our day-to-day life, but it also has definition and it can be defined in this way. Language is a principal method of human communication consisting of words used in a structured and conventional way and conveyed by speech, writing, and gesture. Then, third one is what is a conversation? Conversation is a type of spoken language. Conversation may be defined as informal talk. It is a medium in which people exchange news, views, feelings, and thoughts in a friendly manner. It differs from talk, which is a general term meaning the activity of speaking. Talk is undirectional. It is an informal speech directed at an audience. Conversation, on the other hand, is a two-way communication. Secondly, conversation differs from dialogue, which in its strict sense means written conversation in a book. Dialogue also means discussion on an issue as we have in our day-to-day life with our friends. For example, we say that the dialogue between the New Delhi and the White House is expected to be fruitful. It means that the word dialogue refers to an exchange of views between the representatives of two governments trying to resolve the problem or issues. Thirdly, we must distinguish between conversation and chat. The two share some characteristics. For example, both the types of communications are free and informal. However, chat is little too informal, entertaining, lighter in spirit, and heartier in nature. Fourthly, conversation differs from gossip, which implies talk about the private life of other people. People gossip about other people's corrupt and immoral behavior as well as on any other issues. This is based on a hearsay and rumor. Fifthly, conversation should also be differentiated from discussion, which is a serious conversation between people. People who take part in a discussion consider different aspects of a problem. We talk about group discussion, but not group dialogues or group conversations. Sixthly, conversation must be distinguished from debate. There is also disparity between conversation and debate. Like a discussion, a debate is a formal. In a debate, two or more speakers talk for or against a certain topic or issues. A debate is a persuasive in nature. We conduct debate in politics, education, etc., etc. Of all the modes of communication mentioned above, it is conversation, perhaps, that calls for a great number of personal qualities. It is an art which needs to be developed with care. Good conversation requires creativity, being quick-witted, resourcefulness, wisdom, a sense of tolerance, imaginativeness, and a certain amount of mastery of language. Those who have mastery over the language, one can turn the language according to his choice. For example, a good conversationalist has something to say on every subject under the sun, as well as all the things which are present on this planet. This does not mean that every great scholar or speaker is a good conversationalist. Being a good speaker or having a scholar or intellectual, that is a different thing. For example, as we have good speakers like our Prime Minister Narendra Modi or some political people. In a conversation, we take turns as speakers and listeners. That is to say, this moment I am a speaker and you are a listener, but on the next moment you will be the speaker and I will be a listener. It means speaker will be a listener and listener will be a speaker. A listener has to look for clues that signals the end of one turn and then make a contribution either in verbal or non-verbal form. Dear friends, a conversation centers around a subject. This usual topic of conversation are whether festivals, functions, parties, political issues, ceremonies, etc., etc. It also may be context binds. Context binds a conversation together. A conversation takes place in a situation which consists of a setting of time, setting of place, participants, for example, speakers and listeners, and the topic. The situation may be formal or informal. The formality of the situation depends on the type of occasion, relationship between the participants and the topic. For example, a meeting is a formal occasion or event. The relationship between the speaker and the hearer could be intimate or distant. For example, the relationship between friends is very close, whereas the relationship between persons who are meeting for the first time is a very formal. As we go to the office, then we use formal language with the officials because we are not familiar with that person. That's why we follow that formal communication or formal conversation. The topic of conversation may be a casual one or a technical one. The language of conversation will largely depend on the interactions of these three factors. For example, even if the occasion and the topic are formal, friends may use informal language. There is no restrictions to the conversation between friends. However, there are some very formal occasions too, during which even close friends have to use formal language. So, dear students, there are some certain principles of conversation that conversationalists should usually observe. Some of these principles are briefly discussed below. We'll try to brief all those. The first thing is that make your contribution as informative as necessary. While giving information, you may be more informative, neither more nor less. For example, if I ask you your name, you must be stick to your attitude as well as the sentence you have been asked. You should tell me your name alone and nothing more than that. Whatever the information you have been asked, you have to provide the same answer. The second is that you or one must be truthful. Do not say that for which you do not have evidences of. In other words, do not spread rumors or do not criticize people unless you have evidence. In fact, courtesy and good manners demand that we do not indulge in such acts. The next is that you try to make your contribution relevant. Do not speak on irrelevant matters. Do not digress, do not divert, do not jump from one topic to another. The next is that make your contribution transparent, unambiguous and clear. Frequent use of ambiguity, pun and circumlocution make your speech unclear. Then you should try to make the listener feel cheerful and comfortable. Next is that do not try to impose your things on your listeners. Give him some options. The next component is that whenever possible, try to encourage and praise your listener. Appreciate the listener's contribution as well as the ability. Compliment him or her on his or her success, his achievement, victory, so and so. Try to sympathize with your conversational partner. Do not threaten him or her, his or her image by criticizing and swearing. Try to speak in a natural manner, as do not always speak in a complete sentences. In real life situation, people speak spontaneously and in incomplete sentence. And if possible, try to use colloquial expressions such as chap, fellow, bugs, dude, and so, short forms such as televisions, as well as the halls for the holidays, and contracted forms such as am for I am, and can't for cannot. The hedges, for example, rather, fairly, perhaps, I am afraid, more or less, and so. Try to use plain, simple, straightforward language. For example, say you are going for an evening walk. Do not say you are going for a post-prandial nocturnal perambulation. In short, try to speak naturally, clearly, precisely, economically, and politely.